Thank you. Seniors, graduates, we are so excited to celebrate your accomplishments today. We also want to extend a warm welcome to your families, friends, teachers, and the Board of Education members present who are also with us. At this time, please stand and remove your caps as the Silver Pirate Band and the senior members of the Chamber Choir perform the national anthem.
Under the direction of Mr. Alec Fields, the senior members of the Humboldt High School Silver Pirate Band will play Painted Black by the Rolling Stones.
afternoon, and welcome to the 2023 Boonville High School commencement ceremony. My name is Sarah Marriott, and I'm the superintendent of the Boonville School District. Before we begin our celebration, I ask that we have a moment of silence to honor our friend, educator, BTech director, Ms. Carrie Reisner. Passed away early last night from cancer. Thank you. Well, you guys look amazing. I am so excited to be here today with you guys. I see so many possibilities just sitting right in front of me. And I have had a front row seat to your education for the past few years, and some of you for many more years before that, for which I am truly thankful. You're my favorite class. I can't think of a better way than to leave this district that I have loved for 8 years than to leave it with the class that I love the most. Parents and families, I know you're a bit sad right now, and there's lots of tears, and this is so very hard because it's all gone so very quickly. However, this is a time of celebration. This is exactly what we want to happen for our kids. They're amazing. And even though you may not feel it at this moment, as much as we love them, we do not want them living in our basements 30 years from now. Okay? Love you guys. And finally, I have just a personal quick story and request. So for the past several years, our family vacations have been with boys. It's just boy vacations. And so this summer when traveling with Isaac and his friends, we made a very impromptu stop to the National Football Hall of Fame. Not realizing it was Hall of Fame induction weekend, it was a little bit more crowded than we anticipated. And I had a moment and kind of lost it. And my husband Colin said to me, you know, the boys have never seen you get so mad. They're probably just gonna give you a little side hug at graduation and not a real hug. So Colby, Max, Bryson, and I can't believe I even have to say it, but I will, Isaac, I want a real hug from you when you go across this stage today. All right, so now to introduce our speaker, Mrs. Kelly Smith. Mrs. Kelly Smith is a 1996 graduate of Boonville High School. After a career in nonprofit work, she returned to her alma mater as a teacher in 2019. She's currently in her fourth year as an English communications and dual credit instructor with the district. In addition to teaching, Mrs. Smith is also a published writer who has contributed to the Chicken Soup for the Soul book series 4 times. She lives in Boonville with her husband, Ryan, and her sons, Ben, who is here graduating today, Sam and Rowan Smith. Most recently, Mrs. Smith has been nominated for the Regional Teacher of the Year for the state of Missouri. Welcome, Mrs. Smith.
Good afternoon. Thank you to Dr. Marriott for those kind words. To the class of 2023, it's an honor to be in front of you today. Although for many of you, I was your speech teacher, so it feels like it could be a trick. You know, a few years back, I sat exactly where you're sitting, actually exactly where Hope is sitting, and I graduated from BHS. That was in 1996, and not, as one of my students suggested, during Civil War times. I bet you're feeling a lot of the same things I did on that day, but there is one difference. At my graduation, I didn't hear a single speech about keeping it wholesome, but you're about to. You're about to join me as an alumni of Boonville High School, and Boonville schools are special. They're so special that I moved my family back to my hometown so we could raise our sons here in Boonville schools. And I don't just think our schools are special because they produced Dr. Marriott and me, Mrs. Lorenz, and Mrs. James. More than half of our English department, Missy Walker, Mr. Stock, all of the Brimers, and many more. I'm not trying to remember everyone. I also think our schools are special because they produced you, and I think you're a pretty amazing group. I hope you'll always be proud to be a Boonville graduate. Nothing is perfect in life, but this community, our schools, and the people in them are pretty special. If you remember nothing else, I hope you remember that you were loved here. That doesn't end at graduation. It will follow you throughout your life, just as it has for me. And no, I'm not crying. Your first day at VHS was also my first day at VHS as a teacher. As I look out at you, I can still see those nervous ninth graders walking into my ELA 1 classroom. 70 of you had me for ELA 1. 49 of you had my speech class. 47 of you had me for college prep English, and 28 of you took my film class. So many of you have had me as a teacher 3 or even 4 times. So I've spent a significant amount of time with this particular group of world changers. For almost half of you, I had the honor of being your teacher on your very first and your very last days of high school. When I became your teacher, I never planned to be the wholesome teacher. It was just something that evolved over time. But what does it really mean to be wholesome? This is gonna shock some of you, but keeping it wholesome is actually not just about your language or obeying classroom rules. It was actually rooted in the idea that we should absorb things that are good for us and put out into the world things that are good for the people around us. Putting our phones down and talking to our friends and family face to face, that's wholesome. Helping a neighbor, wholesome. Being of service to your family or your community, the country, what could be more wholesome than that? To me, living in a wholesome way means to extend positivity to those we encounter and to ourselves. This includes the person who serves you lunch or answers the phone at the doctor's office, the person who drops their papers in the hallway, or even the person who cuts you off in traffic, even them. And to whom do we look for inspiration in this way of life? We look to our heroes. Going back to some of the literature we read in room 111, we've learned about all types of heroes. We could look to Atticus Finch, the fictional attorney who stood up for what he thought was right and put his family at great risk to improve his community. That's a hero. We could look to a real-life World War II hero, Louise Amperini, who we learned about in ELA 1. He was adrift at sea for 47 days and then spent 2 years in a prisoner of war camp and emerged to become a national icon for being unbroken. That's a hero. These are wonderful heroes. It's okay to look to our culture for stories to inspire us. I know how many of you admire Patrick Mahomes, FDR, Zach, Lil Uzi, Helen Keller, Taylor Swift. Personally, I'm a Dolly Parton fan. And yet, as great as they are, we know their stories, but they don't know us. They don't drive us to the doctor's office. They don't bring us a meal when we're sick. If we pay attention, we actually encounter heroes every day. Speaking of people like Louise Amperini, who have endured and survived, have you ever met Mrs. Desiree Jones? Did you know she's a childhood cancer survivor who overcame numerous personal tragedies to pursue a long-lasting career? And in 2013, she became the first Black administrator in the Boonville School District ever. Since that time, she's been loving on all of us every day. That's a hero. Miss Gallagher is a paraprofessional at VHS. I don't know if you know this, she was one of the leaders of the movement to preserve and restore the Katy Bridge when it might have been demolished. That's the place where you all go take your prom pictures. She saw a need, she did the work, and she improved her community. She's a real person that you've been passing in the hallways for 4 years. That's a hero. And I hope she's here, Sarah. She's here somewhere. What about the people who sit around your dining room table at Thanksgiving? Or the people who drove you to baseball practices, dance recitals, or held your feet to the fire when your grades weren't where they should be? Talk to the heroes in your life while you can. No matter what you encounter as you leave BHS, your gateway to a wholesome life is how you treat yourself and others, and what heroes you choose, because in 20 years, you're gonna be someone's hero. Some of you already are. You have younger siblings or nieces and nephews, and they're watching you. But in 5, 10, 20 years, all of you will be someone's hero. As you go out in the world and start to chart your life, I hope you'll keep this wholesome question in the back of your mind. What kind of hero do you want to be? Every single one of us is actually a world changer. We change the world little by little every single day by the choices we make. Do we leave people better or worse in our wake? Do we smile and say thank you? Leave a tip, put the shopping cart back, pick up litter, choose our words carefully. Each of you will change the world. In fact, you already have. Life is the ultimate choose your own adventure, because you get to choose what kind of impact you make on the world and all of the people around you. You've already changed the world for me. I've seen acts of kindness and good works from you, big and small, over these past 4 years. When discussing the class of 2023 with one of my colleagues who's known you since middle school, he said, "The thing I will always remember about this class is that they had an 8th grade trip to the St. Louis Zoo." You guys remember it? This is the Laura Spidelli kids. And one of their classmates was having trouble walking and needed to be in a wheelchair. The kids, not the adults, made sure the student in the wheelchair was included all day, never left behind, and never left out. It's so indicative of this group of kids, I think, and it's special to me, not just as your teacher, but as a mom, because my son was in the wheelchair. And so, I leave you with some words from one of my personal heroes, a true wholesome king, Mr. Fred Rogers. On his show, there was a song he'd sing called "It's You I Like." And no, I'm not going to sing, although it would be very on brand for me. When asked about the song, Mr. Rogers said, "When I say it's you I like, I'm talking about that part of you that knows that life is far more than anything you can ever see or hear or touch. That deep part of you that allows you to stand for those things without which humankind cannot survive. Love that conquers hate, peace that rises triumphant over war, and justice that proves more powerful than greed. To the class of 2023, it's you I like. Your names are written on my heart. Get out there and change the world, and keep it wholesome."
Thank you, Mrs. Smith. I now use the word wholesome on a more frequent basis, and I thank you for that. Graduation honors are the highest academic honors bestowed upon seniors as a result of their academic achievement over the last 4 years. These students demonstrated tremendous grit, perseverance, and fortitude in maintaining high academic standards for themselves. Will our 8 students being recognized for summa cum laude please stand? Wearing a gold medal to recognize their exemplary achievement, these students each earned a cumulative GPA of 3.9 to 4.0. Congratulations. Will our 15 students earning magna cum laude please stand? Wearing a silver cord in honor of their academic achievements, these students earned a GPA of 3.75 to 3.889. Congratulations. Will our 14 students earning cum laude would stand. These students are wearing a bronze cord in recognition of their academic achievement of earning a 3.749 to 3.5 GPA. Congratulations. Next year, the class of 2023 will be receiving $90,000 in A-plus scholarship aid, $50,000 in local scholarships, $25,000 in external scholarships, and $450,000 in institutional aid and scholarships from the schools of their choice. The local level scholarships were presented on awards night and will not be read today, but they are in your program. Please join me in a round of applause as we congratulate these students. At this time, we will now begin the presentation of diplomas for the graduating class of 2023. Each of these students has met the criteria for graduation set forth by the state of Missouri and the Boonville Board of Education. Diplomas will be presented by Board of Education President Sam Giroux. The class of 2023 requests the audience to hold its applause until the last graduate has crossed the stage. Thank you for your cooperation.
Adresa Bob Lamb. Alyssa Marie Bartholomew. Shelby Elizabeth Ann Bartholomew. Kayla Leanne Baxter. Connor Michael Basinger. Lakail Jayon Bell.
Kaylee Madison Biesmeyer. Carly Paige Bishop. Peyton Elizabeth Black. Sydney Lynn Blackwell. Samara Louise Brown. Michael Christopher Bulliard. McKenna Grace Campbell. Colby Benton Caton. Shane Lee Chamberlain. Preston Jacob Kramer. Matana Delaney Marie Davidson. Michael Mason DeLeon. Maxwell Jason Epperly. Elizabeth Bonnie Christine Edler. Tyson Atia Ellison. Josiah Levi Elwell.
Braden Michael Andrew Estel. Kinley Jordan Fox. Michael Wayne Fry Jr. Abigail Faith Fimler. Jordan Lane Fimler. William Charlie Gaddis. Braden Michael Gamble. Leah Renee Gerhardt Cook.
Emily Kate Gibson. Alyssa Mae Gross. Heather Michelle Hall. Javon Cortez Harvey. Woo!
Caden Isaiah James Hazel.
Shane Vincent Heigl. Janae Nicole Hodge. Ashlyn Marie Holman.
Jeremy Terrell Humphrey Jr. Garrett Edward Hundley. Kaylee Michelle Hundley. Ethan Lane Hurley. Hayden Andrew Jinks. Jackson Willis Johns. Kendall Lauren Jones. Colin William Kellner.
Azalea Rose Mary Cluck. LaShayla Ann Cordy. Zoe Suzanne Lang. Hannah Sumitra LeGrant. Zachary Thomas Losey. Tucker Aiden Lorenz. Skylar Matthew Lyons. Brandon Ray Mackey.
Tommaso Maritan. Isaac Charles Marriott. Levi Garrett Robert Martin. Wyatt James Martin.
Brendan Davis Martinez Purdy. Trent Michael Maxwell. Kyla Rose McClelland.
Kayla Marie Miller. Adam Joseph Neckerman. Emma Louise Knighted. Benjamin Eugene Newman. Ethan Andrew Northern. Casey Page Northern. Hope Elena O'Brien. Natalie Jean Lisinski Page.
Harrison Teal Parkhurst. Ava Noelle Harmon. Ashley Brooke Pickens. Ember Briseis Elaine Piercy. Cameron J. Polson. Abigail Reese Pulliam. Austin Griffith Rice. Blake Maxwell Richardson.
Carter Mathis Rowlett. Trisha May Alvarez Sancho. Kira Daylin Salter. Logan Alexander Schildmeier. Alexis Daisy Schnitzler. Molly Kate Schuster. Ben Taemin Smith. Caitlin Marie Smith.
Madison Ann Smith. Aaron Robert Strogman.
You want buddy?
Ellen Jean Thurman. Allison Halton Hope Marie Unterreiner. Sawyer James Van Claveren.
Y'all better be loud.
Vincent.
He's next.
Look at him. Oh, that's you.
Desmond Terrell Walker. Eli John Walker.
We did it, guys.
Jonah Daniel Wallace. Bailey McKenna Warren. Ethan Daniel Watson. Lauren Raylan Weimer. Bryson John Wessing. Josie Vega Weedle.
I'm going outside.
Haley Hale Williams. Kaden Cole Williams. Nathaniel Lamar Williams. Claire Elizabeth Winning. Yeah.
Kira Jasmine Wepner. Leah Marie Zibelbein.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause to celebrate the class of 2020.